Hello, this is Kestrel, and welcome back to more Golden Sun, The Lost Age. Last time, we solved this puzzle, and also picked up some keys. This time, we'll probably continue the trend. Oh, I guess this is the way out, which would mean that would be what the stairs I saw earlier were for. Earlier as in last episode. Yeah, that's helpful. Anywho. Let us... Oh, I thought for sure this would be the top. Okay, well... If this is designed the way I would design it... There is probably a... Oh. Okay. That's not exactly how I would have designed it. I would have made it required to go over here. Incidentally. Is what I would have done. So, you know, I'm not the designer for Golden Sun. Good to know. Good to know. Let's heal. And then get back up there. Round two. I need to go this way. And run over there. Now this one, I'm gonna need to climb. Or rather, take. Pop. Look, step in front of, like so. Then I can go like this. And we're over! Is there a thing? No. No, there's not. How about over here? Absolutely not. You know, if I was paying attention, I would have known that without having to check it now. Ooh. Here's the interesting thing about this. If I go over here, my flow power regenerates when I'm over the glowy bits. Whoa! Whoops. I done goofed. So anyway, my flow power regenerates when I'm over the glowy bits. But we're also really damn slow when we're over the glowy bits. So the trick here, basically, is... be over here. But not for too long. Oh, there's a box here. Otherwise, you'll fall into the hole and it'll be bad. Can I? There we go. Phantom's Blade. It's better than my current thing. Let's do... only a little bit better, though. This is a long sword. Okay, let's... you know, I can just walk. But I'll use float here. I mean, it's not really obvious when you're moving, but this decays on a time limit and not just for being over the, and not just by walking. So, yeah. No! I was so close! I guess that's what this is for, though. Oh well, I got the box on the first try. Well, I mean, air quotes first try. I mean, I sort of screwed up my actual first try, but wait. Sheep is faster than Jenna again, despite Jenna's massive... Ooh, that looks cool. I bet it's wind-based, though. Actually, you're not actually faster than Jenna. You're slightly slower, but you're within the sphere of it being possible to go... Whoops, that's not right. With it being possible to go faster than her. So, you know, basically the same thing. Avoid this one, and this time avoid this one without No! That's actually really hard. It's harder than the other side. It's because of the placement. You need to get it just right. Kind of annoying, actually. I'd rather I had a little bit more leeway, to be honest. Like here, I don't even need to be over the damn pit, and I can do it. This one, though, is closer, and... it's staggered. Well, whatever, I did it. We're almost on... this is probably the outside, actually. Yep. We light the arrow, and that should turn on the other half of the lighthouse. Or rather, it should open the cover is what it should do. Yep, there we go. Cover removed. So now, all we need to do is throw in the Jupiter Star, and the lighthouse will be lit. You know, it's probably actually fastest to retreat, rather than walking all the way out. But I'm gonna walk down. It is what I'm gonna do because, well, pretty much because I feel like it. There is no addition. There is no, there's no special thoughts put behind this decision. It will probably take a little bit longer to do it this way, but, you know, whatever. I can, however, say with certainty that we will actually light the lighthouse at the end of the episode, so, you know, that's nice. It might be a long episode, actually. I'm not sure. I'm not entirely sure, because, like, I know what's coming up. Obviously, I know what's coming up. And there are some things that could take a little bit of time. I'm not telling you what, you'll have to wait and see. It won't be that long a wait. But I don't know how long it will take. Like, it could be a little bit of time, or it could be a lot of time. Wait, what? What? I guess I just wasn't quite close enough for its liking? Anyway, we're down there here now, so... Yeah, jump off, and in, and... Okay, now down here, then up the other side, I guess. No, not hover. We don't use bloody hover to use these things. I've done that twice already. I don't intend to do it a third time. Then again, I didn't intend to do it the first two times either, so my intentions may mean little here. Pretty much, yeah. I want to do that because I want to walk into here. Because in here is the way to climb upward. Oh, for crying out loud. This is number 4! I guess I could have actually taken the shortcut. Well, I mean, it's not really a shortcut. Well, it's a little bit of a shortcut. I could have taken the chain swing in the middle to cut having to do this the fourth time. I could have... Actually, no, I couldn't have done the third or second times because of retreat. Actually, I could have done it the second time, but you didn't see it the second time. The second time was off-screen. I digress. There was the chain thing in the middle I could have taken. That probably would have saved me a little bit of time. If nothing else, it would have meant I didn't need to do this bloody puzzle again. Yeah, like right here. Yeah, that would have probably saved me a minute, now that I think about it. Well... Oh. Huh. Well, that just happened. It's Maya and Garrett. And Ivan and Isaac. Isaac, who's not mute, I'll mention. Yeah. Well, I mean, he may be trying to kill me right now, but, you know, I would basically consider him my friend. He's certainly Jenna's friend, at the very least. Yeah, that's the thing, though. Are they in trouble? Oh my! Yeah, I'd say they're in trouble. How the hell did they manage to even do that? The button for that bridge is, like, way off. You would need to step on that deliberately. Yeah. I mean, maybe you could help try to pull him up, Maya. No? I mean, Garrett's a pretty big guy. I guess that's sort of fair. I mean, Maya isn't really made of muscles. She's more about the healing synergy type stuff. Mostly just the healing, actually. Yeah, you do. What? Wait, the bridge should come up. No one's standing on the bouton now. Well, they're huge assholes. Mm-hmm. I feel like, no, you have not. I mean, you haven't really done a back riddle wrong. Do they know Satyr Samarity? Of course they know Satyr Samarity. We're from the Fire Clan! In fact, I am Merity's sister! Apparently. Wait, no, what? Wait, what? No, this seems important. Also, you're saying a lot more than you were the last time we met. Okay, so, we actually know enough that I feel comfortable elaborating on this. Because we know enough to figure this out on our own at this point. Prox, when he says Prox will recover from the edge, he means that literally. Prox is on the edge of the world, and the world is shrinking without the help of, without alchemy to sustain it. So the reason that all these people from Prox are lighting the lighthouses, or rather blackmailing us into lighting the lighthouses, is so that they can restore alchemy and save Prox from falling off the edge of the world. So, you know, their motivations are, well, I wouldn't really call them pure. Cerdos and Merides were grade A villains. But nonetheless, if not pure, then certainly nuanced, and somewhat noble. I mean, their motivations are noble. Their methods certainly are not. Mm-hmm. Yeah, how's that working out for you? Alex is not really invested in actually confronting these guys. He don't care, like, at all. Although, I want to know how the hell you two got this high in the lighthouse without a Jupiter adept. That's what's really interesting, I think. Ruh-roh. I mean, no matter how I slice this, I don't think it'll end well. Still, you know, I bet that those two are the ones who set the bridge off in the first place. I mean, I can think of no reason that Isaac and Garrett could have reasonably fallen for that trap on their own. In fact, they would have probably been coming from the left side. So, the two fire adepts would have been waiting on the left for them to cross from the right, because the only way to do the only other way to cross would be, wait, give me a minute here. The only other way to cross is to solve the puzzle in this room, which may or may not involve a synergy they don't have. No, I think you can actually just do it with just pushing things. Can I get over on this side? Also, I should save. Because I'm not... Well, I mean, I... No, I cannot. Okay, we'll go on the other side. We need to get over there to help someone. Not sure who we're gonna help, but, you know, help someone. It'll be at least one of the two. I don't need to actually fix this. This is just for the... Wait. Alex! Oh, he just teleported right in. I mean, yes, that's why we're here. Also, we should probably go help outside. No, that's not all I'm gonna do. Yeah. You don't say. Yeah, I'm sure. You definitely don't want us to help anyone outside. Oh? Oh, you just healed us. I mean, I guess you are a water adept. Okay, now here's the thing. I want to do this really quick. This is literally the only chance in the whole game we have to do this. Even now, I want to run to Maya and give her my aid. It seems I am weak as well. I suppose I have no choice but to part ways with Cadio and Karst. Alex wants us to help them. He has a thing for Maya. And this is the only way he can help Maya without jeopardizing himself. It's debatable whether he would even be able to take on those two. I mean, he's a damn powerful adept, but he's not really a fighter. I mean, he's more a dedicated caster, really. Quite possibly the strongest one in the game, but nonetheless, maybe not a match for these two assholes. Not 2-1 anyway. Also, we just saw a battle where we were playing, air quotes, as Isaac and Ivan. I mean, a shame, air quotes. Yeah, I guess we should probably help. I mean, frankly, I like Isaac better. Even though Isaac might try to kill me later, I like him a hell of a lot better than you two assholes. Oh? Yeah, that did happen. Almost like we haven't lit the lighthouse yet. Also, in fairness, this is the Jupiter lighthouse, not the Venus lighthouse. It's probably not as directly connected to the Earth. Yep, we are, right after we make sure you don't kill anyone. I mean, I'm not betraying you, insofar as I was never really on the same team. I mean, I'm not gonna let him live. If it comes to it, I'll kill him myself, but not unless he makes me. After all, as I said, I like him a hell of a lot better than you two assholes. So here's the thing, these two are actually pretty smart people. They've sort of been playing the thugs for Alex. I don't know if that's been mentioned or not yet, but it is the case. I mean, I'm gonna light the beacon, so. I don't trust you, these assholes, though. I mean, frankly, I don't want to leave until you have already left. How generous of you. Man, this is completely out of character for how I was playing Isaac. I was playing like Maximum Asshole Isaac. Or at least Maximum Narcissism Isaac. Oh, I guess I'm climbing to the top first. I feel like they're gonna turn on me the moment I light the lighthouse. I mean, I like that they've abandoned these two, but I feel pretty confident that I'm gonna be attacked the moment the lighthouse has been lit. Like, there's just no way I'm lighting a lighthouse without any sort of encounter, you know? It's just not happening. There's gotta be some sort of boss at the top. I came literally straight here. I could not have possibly reached here any faster. Yeah, I should have saved. I mean, I already saved before I started this encounter, so worst case. But, in it goes. You know, this is a lot more simonious than it was with Venus, where Sadras sort of just threw it in the hole. No, it like floated up to it and everything this time. Okay, there's still a fair amount of shaking. I don't think the Earth's gonna literally split in twain, though. And looks like we're lit! Yeah, a lot less dramatic than Venus was. And now is the part where they try to kill us. What? I have not! I mean, first of all, I've been doing exactly what... What's the village called again? I don't even remember. Man, I heard it like 10 minutes ago, and I don't remember. That's bad. Anyway, I'm doing exactly what the village wants me to. So I haven't betrayed them. And I was never on the same team as you in the first place. So I don't need to betray you. I mean, I know why you don't need me. It's because, obviously, you are Mars adepts. So you can probably climb the Mars Lighthouse yourself. Prox, that was it. Also, the lighthouse is right by Prox, apparently. But no, mostly it's the climbing thing. Again, though, I really have to wonder how the hell you got up here without a freaking Jupiter adept. I mean, I guess I solved all the puzzles. Pretty much all the puzzles in this lighthouse, once solved... At least for climbing straight up, you don't need a Jupiter adept after you've turned everything on. Yes. This is the part where you kill me, or at least attempt to kill me. I mean, I haven't actually. You're just kind of really petty. Anyway, it's time to fight these assholes with just two of... Okay, this is probably not going to go very well. We do have a water adept though, so we should at least be able to lay down the damage. I'm not going to use my genie. Also, both of the people can heal, so that's really good. Having said that, I'm not going to use my genie yet, simply because, well, because I want my stat boosts. I mean, that's really all there is to it. Plus, I can still hit pretty damn hard. I think I'm going to do a repeat of that, then I'm going to heal myself. And I should be able to get away with more or less alternating in this manner. Wait, what? What? No! What have he done? Although that's actually probably a good reason to... Wait, the battle... Oh, the rest of my party's here. That wasn't so bad. I wonder if my if the damage will reset or not. Like, I don't know if this was... I don't know what the cue is for resetting. If it was time-based or damage-based or what. I kept my damage, though. So, you know, that's a thing. You just heal everyone. I mean, I can do mass healing now, and you're at the back of the freaking party. That is so annoying. I'm gonna be very nearly in the exact opposite order of what I would prefer. Yeah, that's a problem. Ooh, that looks familiar. But you did it on Jenna, who probably... Wow, it did that much damage against Jenna? Ugh. That is pretty powerful. I should probably be attacking, Karst, actually, because chances are she has less HP. But, well, I'm not. So there you go. Actually, I'd rather you heal Jenna. You are going to keep using Diamond Bird. You are going to use... Man, your synergy is not actually that good. Let's try using... I mean, it is pretty good. Just not against these guys. You're sort of a fire adept. Your synergy is not going to deal that much damage against... Oh, it didn't work. Against more fire adepts. Oh man, I would have been upset if that had one-shot someone. This is probably going to hurt a lot. I mean, about 50% more damage than against Jenna. Keeping in mind, Pierce probably has higher base defense. Oh, okay. Again, if these fights are being if their HP is being reset between each time we come out, I'll actually be kind of upset. But I have my whole party now, so let's really wail on them. Hopefully, man, hopefully I don't hurt too much on the synergy front. Ply, man, like, what are you even gonna bloody do? I will actually use the genie with you. I want to boost... Actually, let's boost attack power. Dealing more damage is good. And... Shine Plasma. Odyssey is actually probably my single most damaging... outside of some Ginny and summons, it's probably the single most damaging thing I can do right now. I mean, technically Diamond Birch could potentially deal more damage because they're weak against it, but realistically, Felix should hit that much harder. Pretty much. Use more Odyssey, use more... Actually, you are going to use Shade. You are going to use Cool Aura. And do I have like a fire? I have fire wind. I have fire earth. I don't have any water ones to do that. That's unfortunate. Okay, you will restore PP on Felix. And yeah, that filled me most of the way up. Glad I have Cool Aura now. Okay, oh, I can use this now. That's nice. I'm probably gonna just set my water genie though. Or, you know, let's just use Mercury. You are... I still want to use more Aura. You are going to unleash Megara, though. Oh, I skipped through the first part of that. Whoops. And even more attack power! Yeah, that's... I can probably get that damage a little bit higher. Like, I feel like I can probably hit 400. But having said that, 400 from a synergy... None of that, but a base class synergy and not a genie or a summon is kind of insane. There are probably a few endgame unleashes that can do more damage than that. And like I said, there's a specific genie and summons. And definitely summons that can do more damage than that. But that's about it. Like, 400 is definitely the high end for damage outside of special cases. Yeah, let's do that. Still standing? Unfortunately, though, we've also reached the part of the game where bosses start having things that screw with your Ginny. Most of them aren't too bad. They're things like, Karst thing isn't really too terrible. It just puts one of them on standby. There's a few bosses, like two or three, including the final boss of the game, I will add, that have Ginny Storm. What Ginny Storm does is it takes every single Ginny that is set and it puts it on standby. And it's kind of terrible. Let's see, I want you to use Flower. I want you to use... You know, don't bother using Flower. Use Odyssey some more. You can use Shade again. You're gonna use Cool Aura again, and you're gonna use some more Shine Plasma. And it kinda just wrecks you really easily. However, there's also a single target version, which I'm pretty sure a few... I don't actually know if any mandatory bosses have it. I'm pretty sure a few optional ones do, though. Oh hey, I killed him. Awesome! Drops my attack power, and of course it hit Piers, but not Felix. Yeah. Mercury! Aura! Shine Plasma! At least I... I guess that's not just Jenna's shtick. At least I think that the single target one is in this game. It honestly might just be a Dark Dawn thing. Because I know that in Dark Dawn, the only enemy that has... there's only one enemy that has Ginny Storm in Dark Dawn. And it is the super boss. The very hardest one. Which is sort of fair, because frankly, Ginny... Screwing with your Ginny a little bit makes sense for hard bosses. Otherwise, it is pretty easy to just walk over a lot of bosses by just spamming summons. But taking out all of your Ginny is like overkill bullshit territory. Put it on the final boss, sure. Or not the final boss, sorry. Put it on the one thing that's harder to beat than anything else, sure, why not? But on anything else, it's just bullshit. Even on that boss, actually, it's kind of bullshit. But you know, we aren't there. We aren't even close to there. Anyway. We did it! Yay! Barely. I mean, I wouldn't say barely. It was no walk in the park, but it wasn't exactly the hardest fight in the world either. It was no Doom Dragon. Wait, no. It's not called Doom Dragon. It was no Fusion Dragon. I mean, I don't think we were really planning on finishing off in the first place. And also what Jenna said. I sincerely doubt they would kill their parents if you don't return, considering Cedrus and Meridi are already dead. I mean, I feel like if I try to kill you, Alex will probably step in. Yeah, I called it. I mean, I really doubt our parents would die. I really doubt they'd be killed. But, well, I was pretty sure this would happen. To be honest. They can barely walk right now. I'm smarter than that. If they want to leave, they'll do it now. I mean, I'm totally comfortable with leaving them here to die. It's the best I could have expected from them, so... What indeed? Maybe so, yeah. They've actually taken the Elemental Star, haven't they? We don't have it anymore. First of all, yay, more inventory space! But also, that means Isaac would have no reason to attack us, since we are in no position to light the final lighthouse anyway. Although, let's be honest, we're totally gonna do it. Why the hell would we not at this point? We would be submitting our world to a slow yet inevitable end. Hi, Isaac, long time no see. I'm with you on that. They are massive jerks. Yeah, well, we can explain. Yeah, that's putting it lightly. Yeah, that's a good idea, Ivan. I like the cut of your jib. They didn't even give me... Wait, Isaac just nodded his head. What? What would happen if I said no there, I wonder? Right, well, the length of... Oh, it's doing it automatically. Okay then, I guess that's a non-issue. I was just gonna say, I'm not gonna end the episode anyway, despite the ridiculous length. Oh, I could stop up here if I wanted to, but I'm not going to! There's something... This is sort of stupid long, but there's something very specific I want to have before I end the episode. Because it'll make... Well, frankly, there's something I want to do during the break. And it'll be sort of awkward if I stop up here to try to do that. So I'm not going to take the break until I'm done. Until I've actually finished. Because there's... Man, I was right that this would take for... Oh, I need to fix the damn order of my party. Damn it! Really? Well, that's a little bit disappointing. Oh, Jenna missed. As usual. She does do that a lot, though. Like, I'm not even imagining that, am I? I think she has legitimately missed far more than anyone else. You go there, and we're good. Now, where are those assholes? Actually, no, I feel pretty comfortable calling Isaac an asshole. Sort of Garrett, too. Admittedly, Maya and Ivan are pretty cool. Seriously, though, where are they? In the inn? I mean, I want to stay at the inn anyway. I mean, they have to be around here somewhere. Maybe they're at the wings. Maybe. That seems plausible. Yeah, let's try there. Oh, hey, the other wing is gone. And there's actually no one here. Like, at all. Are they in the ruins, maybe? Reveal! No, oh, wait, what? Oh, I lost Sheba, so I lost my reveal? Man, that's kind of stupid. Reveal! I mean... Yeah, I didn't really think there would be anyone in here, to be honest. No, there's no one in here. So, are they in town? Maybe they'll show up if I try to leave. Well, I mean, there's one building I haven't looked in. They could be in there. I mean, there's more than one building I haven't looked in, but no, it's locked. Okay, well, if it's locked, then there's only really one place they could be. Wait. Yeah, we'll wait on it. At the ship. So, you know, let's head there. There we go. Much better. Even though my order is still a little screwed because of Jenna, but you know, whatever. We'll work it out later. Yeah, because there was a dock here, and there's no one in the town at all. So... Oh! I mean, no, I wasn't. Where in Con? I was just there, and they were not. So where the hell are they, Jenna? You tell me. You tell me. Cause seriously, I want... Have you looked at the damn clock? It's at 41 minutes and 27 seconds. My time, it'll be shorter for you guys. But even so, come on! I can't be wasting my time like that, and there is no one there! So come on, Jenna, spit it out! Where the hell are they? I guess I just need to try all the rest of the doors until I find one that opens. Ugh. I guess I could be cutting battles, but you know, at this point, why even bother? I'm already over 40 minutes. What's the what's 30 seconds gonna save me? Or are they over here? Obviously not. It's locked. The item shop is locked. Okay, transporting the wings. I already looked in the inn. This one's actually open. But they're not in here. Oh, there's a whole other area back here. Have I been up here? Hmm. Well, this is where they are. I'm glad you kept your promise, Felix. I won't actually be doing much talking for myself, per se, so much as to let these assholes do it for me. No. That is true. We did help you not die. I mean, he really, really hasn't, but no one else sees it that way. I mean, the public at large doesn't really see it that way, so... Yeah, that would have been nice. Mm-hmm. I mean, I feel that the people of Vale would have understood. I mean, they certainly wouldn't have helped you with that knowledge, but at the same time, they probably wouldn't have held it against you too much afterwards. Yeah. Mm-hmm. No one at all! No one at all. Are you bloody listening? They're being held hostage. Yes, we could. There is that. Also, we're gonna light the lighthouses anyway. It's sort of personally, I want the power of alchemy at my fingertips. I mean, don't you want to rule the world? But also, there's a whole part about it, the world's slowly coming to an end if we don't, which is kind of a big deal, I feel. Plus, there's also the part where it makes civilization just a whole lot better. You know, you just need to not destroy yourself with your own power. That's really the key here. Incidentally, Dark Dawn, that right there is destroying yourself with your own power. Don't do that 30 to 60 years from now. I'm gonna go with 30. I think that's the more reasonable figure. But I don't actually remember the exact time frame. Yes. I mean, it's not that I'm that much smarter, although I am a lot smarter. It's just that you were that stupid, Garrett. Wow. He's been back for less than an hour, and I'm already laying on to Garrett. Oh? Isn't that, like, Ivan's maybe mother or something? She definitely looks familiar. I definitely met her in Golden Sun 1. Maybe it wasn't Isaac's maybe mother, but still. She's related to the other purple-haired person I saw later. I mean, not literally related. Related as in from the same area. Not related as in, blood relation. Oh, well, that's interesting. Ivan was born... Oh yeah, she's totally Ivan's mother. Oh? Wait, you're Ivan's sister?! Well, I just wow. I mean, I was just saying that you were his mother, so obviously I wasn't that far off, but even so, I'm surprised. Oh yeah, we've lit Jupiter, water, and Earth. Jupiter for the wind, Mercury for the water. Earth doesn't really offset those. It's gonna get pretty cold. And Karst is in the extreme north. Even were everything right, it would be like pretty damn frozen. With those particular lighthouses lit, it'll be like way worse. Oh? Oh? Are you saying what I think you're saying? Meet us at the inlet next episode. Well, I can't wait to see what that does, but I actually will wait because I am hungry and I'm gonna go make dinner after this. But in the meantime, I mean, I would never, ever describe Jenna as calm. Ever. Waiting for it? Sure. Yeah, do it. Do it! Do it! Yeah! Isaac and his party have joined our party! It's amazing, and our Ginny are all screwed up, but we have all of them. Except, weirdly, you have all of the... Oh, no, you don't, actually. Yeah, so we're gonna need to fix this around, but we'll do that later. Also, okay, you didn't actually get reassigned. So when I was saying you only get 9 Ginny in that this game, that was sort of half true. I'm pretty sure it is 9. But we're gonna get enough to fill these guys up to 9 as well. Having said that, here's the reason I wanted to wait until I got these guys. Between episodes, I'm gonna sort out all my Ginny and my party and equipment. Man, there's gonna be a lot of work to be done. But the end result is that I'm probably gonna have a slightly different leading party. Also, note that these guys are actually lower level than me. I guess I finished at 29. Man, I thought it was in at least the early 30s. Anyway, I'm gonna sort my party around, sort my inventory around, and I'm gonna change my Ginny so that I'm not mono elemental classes anymore. I'm not 100% sure how I'm gonna do that, but I'll show you when I'm done. At any rate, I'm on WoW, I'm over 50 minutes. This has been a very long episode of Let's Play Golden Sun, The Lost Age with Chaos Blue, and have a great day. Bye!